Now, Irish singer Sinead O'Connor, known for her hit 90s song Nothing Compares to You, has died at the age of 56. Her family announced the news, but the cause of death was not disclosed. O'Connor was known to have changed the image of women in the music in the early 90s with her shaved head and shapeless wardrobe, a statement to the challenge the pop culture's notion of femininity and sexuality. She was also remembered for her strong views on religion as she ripped up a photo of Pope John Paul II in her appearance on Saturday Night Live. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are the news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
Minister Justin Trudeau surprised Filipinos when he dropped by unannounced during the colorful Fun Philippines festivities held recently in Toronto. Trudeau personally extended his greetings and expressed his support for the Filipino community in Canada.
Our ability to come together and celebrate the Philippines, all the cultures and foods and languages that come together to enrich our country so significantly, to celebrate all the hardworking Filipino Canadians who are there every day as small business owners, as community leaders, as frontline health workers.
In his speech, Trudeau acknowledged the vibrant and creative spirit of the Filipino Canadian community, which he said is crucial in fostering and strengthening the close relationship between the Philippines and Canada.
This moment of looking how we can be strong together, how we can be there for each other, how we can support each other as communities through difficult times, this is what Canada is all about.
Trudeau later went around and talked to the vendors, shook their hands, and posed for selfies with them.
More good news for the Filipino community, new representation in the Trudeau cabinet.
Mabuhay. I, Richie Valdez, do swear.
Richie Valdez, a member of parliament, has just been appointed as new minister for small business. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau announced the cabinet reshuffle Wednesday and included Valdez's appointment to the Ministry of Small Business, a new standalone portfolio that used to be a part of the Ministry of Export Promotion and International Trade. Valdez got emotional as she took her oath of office as part of the Trudeau cabinet. This is a promotion for Valdez, the first Filipina elected to the House of Commons representing Streetsville, Mississauga in Ontario. Valdez, a rising star in the Liberal Party, is one of seven rookie MPs to be appointed to the cabinet in this latest reshuffle.
So help me God.
And finally, a new short film that captures the spirit of giving among Filipinos.
Tay, ano pong gusto niyong ilagay namin sa kahon?
A Filipino-Canadian film student launched his first short film, Return to Country, which centers on the Filipino tradition of sending balikbayan boxes to the Philippines. Eric Cervania, who was born and raised in Canada, shares his inspiration for creating the story and how his family helped make it happen.
My mom and dad, they've been making the balikbayan box for a long time. In second year in film school, where I realized I wanted to tell a story about not only from the Filipino perspective, but also the Filipino-Canadian perspective.
Cervania shares his insights with other aspiring filmmakers.
Go for it. Don't be afraid. Every story is worth telling.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
The U.S. Federal Reserve raises interest rates by 25 basis points, citing still elevated inflation. The hike, the Fed's 11th in its last 12 meetings, set the benchmark overnight rate in the 5.25 to 5.5% range. And that's a level last seen before the 2007 housing market crash. Fed Chairman Jerome Powell says any future policy decisions would be made on a meeting-by-meeting basis, not ruling out another hike in September.
It is certainly possible that we would raise funds again at the September meeting if the data warranted. And I would also say it's possible that we would choose to hold steady at that meeting. I think you'd take everything into account when you start cutting rates. It would depend on a wide range of things. And when people are writing down rate cuts next year, you know, it just is a sense that inflation is coming down and we're comfortable that it's coming down and it's time to start cutting rates. I think, but I mean, there's a lot of uncertainty between what happens, you know, in the next meeting cycle, let alone the next year, let alone the year after that.
Though inflation data since the Fed's June meeting has been weaker than expected, policymakers have been reluctant to alter their hawkish stance until there is more progress in reducing price pressures.